Welcome to Proven Doctor with another episode of ECG Basics. In this video, we will talk about the interpretation of normal ECG waves, segments, and intervals. P wave represents the atrial depolarization. The P wave is best evaluated in lead 2. Normally, the P wave duration is less than 0.12 milliseconds and the amplitude is less than 0.25 millivolt in the limp leads and 0.15 millivolt in the precordial leads. The normal P wave is upright and monophasic in the leads 1 and 2. It's inverted in the lead AVR. Normally, the P wave is biphasic in the lead V1. But its negative deflection is less than 0.1 millivolt. PR segment represents the impulse conduction through the atrioventricular node. The PR segment serves as an isoelectric line, baseline. The PR, so-called PQ interval, starts at the onset of the P wave and finishes at the onset of QRS complex. The normal PR interval ranges from 0.12 seconds to 0.20 seconds. QRS complex reflects the depolarization of the ventricles. It always has variations between the leads. The QRS complex consists of Q, R, and S waves. The first downward wave is called the Q wave. All upward waves are called R waves. Often, the QRS complex begins from the R wave, so it has no Q wave. If there are more than one R wave, the second one is called R prime wave, the third one is called R bis wave, etc. Any negative deflection after R wave is called S wave. It's important that waves are referred only to deflection crossing the baseline. Large waves are marked by capital letters and small ones are marked by lowercase letters. There are different variations in morphology of the QRS complex. It may be called RS, R, QRS, QR, QS, RSR prime, RR prime, RSR prime, S prime. Normal width of the QRS complex should not exceed 0.10 seconds. Normal Q wave represents the depolarization of the ventricular septum. The normal Q wave duration is less than 0.03 seconds. Its amplitude is less than 2 millimeters and less than 1/4 of the subsequent R wave. Deep Q wave in AVR is a normal finding. Septal Q wave is found in leads 1, AVL, V5 to V6. The R wave should be absent or very low in leads V1 and in AVR. Normally, there is R wave progression in the precordial leads. The amplitude of R and S waves should not be less than 0.5 millivolt in at least one limp lead and 1 millivolt in at least one precordial lead. Too high amplitude of the R wave indicates the ventricular hypertrophy, but it may be found in healthy young athletic people and people over 40 years old. The amplitude of the R wave should not exceed 2 millivolt in all limp leads and 1.1 millivolt in AVL. R wave should not be higher than S wave in lead V1. The sum of amplitudes of S wave in V1 and the amplitude of R wave in V5 or V6 should be less than 3.5 millivolt. ST segment in healthy people may be at the baseline or have some elevation no more than 0.1 millivolt in any lead, except the leads V2 till V3. Where it may be elevated by less than 0.15 millivolt in women and 0.2 millivolt in men 40 years old and more, or 0.25 millivolt in men younger than 40 years old. Downsloping or horizontal ST segment depression less than 0.05 millivolt is considered to be normal, as well as upsloping ST segment depression. T wave reflects the ventricular repolarization. The T wave should be positive in all leads except AVR. It may be positive or negative in V1. Usually, the highest amplitude of T wave is present in the leads V2 till V3. Normally, the T wave is asymmetric. Downslope is steeper than upslope. The T wave is concordant to the QRS complex. This means that a positive T wave follows a positive QRS complex, and vice versa. There are no exact criteria to characterize the amplitude of T wave, but some authors describe that the normal T wave has an amplitude from 0.1 to 0.5 mV in limb leads and from 0.1 to 1 mV in the precordial leads. T wave inversion is considered to be pathological if the amplitude of the negative T wave is more than 0.1 mV. QT interval is measured from the beginning of the QRS complex to the end of the T wave. The maximum slope intercept method is used to determine the end of the T wave. The last one is the intercept between the isoline with a tangent drawn by the maximum slope of the T wave. The QT interval depends on the heart rate. It prolonges at a slower heart rate and shortens at a faster heart rate. Prolongation of the QT interval correlates with a higher risk of sudden cardiac death. So in order to involve the influence of the heart rate in the QT interval, many formulas are discovered. Among them, Bazette formula is used most often. QT corrected is equal to QT divided by square root of RR interval. QT corrected is normal if it's less than 440 milliseconds in men or 460 milliseconds in women, and it's more than 350 milliseconds. Prolongation of QT corrected interval more than 500 milliseconds is strongly associated with an increased risk of sudden cardiac death. Normally, the U wave has the same direction as the T wave. Its amplitude is not more than 0.2 millivolt or 25% of the height of the T wave. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more of our videos, please subscribe and hit the like button.